Are you looking to convert more website visitors into leads? Well, CTAs inside of HubSpot are the way to do that.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
CTAs are one of the functions inside HubSpot that allow you to place a custom call to action. That's what CTA stands for. And those calls to action lead someone to a page for a conversion opportunity. So that might be sending them to a page to register for a webinar, or sending them to a page where they are going to request an ebook, or maybe just a consultation. So let's go ahead and look at how to set those CTAs up and some of the tracking information you can get with this feature. All right, so inside the calls to action, right now I'm in our account and we have multiple CTAs set up, but I'm gonna set up a new one and show you how to do that. But first, I'm gonna show you inside HubSpot where this lives in our blog. So this is a blog post on HubSpot versus WordPress. It's something people ask us a lot, so we decided to write a post about it. And inside of this blog, you'll see that this right here is a graphic, but this is actually a CTA. So this is an image CTA that we put together for people to take an action and say, you know what, I might want to request this resource. If you scroll to the bottom of this article, we also have another CTA down here that is essentially sending them to the same page, but it's designed a little bit differently. So these are image CTAs. We're going to set up two CTAs today. One's going to be a button, which is most common when you first start using HubSpot, and the other one's going to be an image like the ones I just showed you here. So inside of this calls to action area, you're going to be inside marketing and lead capture and CTAs. Now I'm gonna click create CTA. And when it does that, it's gonna pull up this three-part setup feature here. And this is what that button looks like. If you wanna style your button a little bit differently, besides the features you have available here, you might need to reach out to someone who works inside of the HubSpot platform and can do some CSS for you, but we can set up a very basic CTA here. So this is this new call to action. This is where we're gonna put our text. So I'm actually gonna set up a CTA today to download or request a case study. So I'm gonna click download our case study template here. And so that's a pretty wide button. So you can see that it's 424 pixels wide. I probably want a little bit smaller CTA, so it might be download the case study. And then we have a couple of different styles of buttons here. So again, one of those tips for when you're setting up HubSpot and making sure that you have a consistent experience on your website is just choose the style and stick with it. And then if you wanna change it, go back and change all of them. But right now we'll stick with this primary style. It has a little bit of a gradient to it and an outline. I can stylize this button color to my colors for my brand. So I'm gonna choose that one here that's already loaded. And for advanced options, I can choose to fit the text. So that means that this button is going to be as wide as that text that I have here, or I can uncheck this and then just choose to have the button be as large as I want it. So you can see that here, or as big as I want it. Obviously that's not going to work. So we're going to choose fit to text here. And then there's where that custom CSS is. So right now I've got our button set up. I'm going to click next. And inside, this is the internal name. So if I go back to this screen on my left, that's a little bit grayed out here, that's where you're gonna go looking for that CTA. So in other videos, we've talked about making sure you name your things consistently inside of HubSpot, just to make sure that when someone else goes in to use your portal, you can find the things that you've put inside here. So we're gonna call this CTA case study button version 1. And this URL redirect is, so when someone clicks the button, that's what this URL redirect is here for. So if I want to send them to an external website, so if maybe you're using GoToWebinar and you don't have it integrated with HubSpot yet and you want to send them to, you know, the webinar registration page, we use this one most often because this is going to be a page on HubSpot, such as a landing page. If you wanted to use your meeting link, we have a couple of videos that show you how to set up your meeting links and use those for booking meetings, booking consultations. You can also do that here, you know, downloading files, emailing someone, posting a phone number, or having someone call you. Those are all options. Today we're going to show you the HubSpot page using one of our landing pages. So this is going to load all the pages that we have inside of HubSpot. So if you're setting up a CTA for the first time and you want to send someone to, let's say, download an ebook, but you haven't set up that landing page yet, you want to go do that first. So refer to the video we have about setting up the landing page first, and then you can go in here and create this CTA. So I'm gonna go to the landing page about the case study template that we have. So here, the way I've named these inside of HubSpot, I know this is a landing page because it's LP, and I know this is the thank you page that comes after that because it's TY. Now this one, since there isn't any abbreviation in front of it, I know this is a blog post. So here I'm gonna go landing page. So when someone clicks this button, it will take them to this landing page. I don't want them to open a new window. If you have campaigns set up, you can select one here so that the CTA lives under that campaign. We're gonna leave that blank for now, and I'm gonna click save. All right, so this is what this button looks like, and I can go ahead and close this, or I'm gonna show you a couple of other variations here. So if I click on this Create Smart, you can use different CTAs with different display rules. So depending on what their device type is, let's say they're gonna be on a mobile device. Now I can configure a rule that says, okay, I want the button to look like this for that particular person. So there's a bunch of features here you can play with to do that. If I actually go to multivariate test, I can create different variations of this button depending on a couple of different options as well too. So if I wanted to say download the case study, let's say, how about get the facts, I'm going to go next. Then I've got a variation of this and I can go ahead and put that into practice. So I'm going to go back and cancel that out, and we're just gonna close this out because it's already created. So there's that CTA button that we just created there. So that's the button version. That's often what you might use in, let's say, a page where you're gonna download the email or download the resource in an email where you're clicking the button to register for an ebook or a webinar. But I'm gonna show you how to use an image because this is what we have here on this page. And this just, it gives me a little bit more appeal as to like, what am I opting in for? So I'm gonna create a CTA, same style here, but we're gonna click on image button instead. So here I'm gonna browse my images, and I may have some available here inside of HubSpot already, but for this one, we're gonna choose to upload one from our file. And I've got this CTA one, write a case study that helps you close more deals. So I'm gonna click open. It's gonna load here inside of HubSpot. I'm gonna click on that, it's gonna load here. Again, we've got this styled so that it looks like this is a button, but in fact, the whole image is a button. And then we've styled it so that our width is 1200 by 400. And here we've got, let's go ahead and make this 800 by 267. So I wanna go ahead and insert alt text because this is gonna show up on the blog page here, and we wanna make sure we have alt text. So we're gonna say case study image. And next, and then again, go ahead and name your CTA. We're going to name this CTA download case study image. Here, I'm going to go to that same landing page, LP underscore, actually, I'm just going to search case study. There we go. And then I'm going to click save. Very good. All right, so now I've got these two CTAs loaded in here, and right now I don't have any views or any clicks, but I will show you, let's go ahead and add this to a blog post to see how this works. So I've got a draft blog post here called How to Write a Great Case Study. I'm gonna open this. And I've already written this, but I'm gonna show you where to insert this. We've got a couple things already in this blog post, but we've got, so this here is also a CTA, but it's not something that I'm necessarily saying, hey, you need to go convert on this, but we do insert these as images, image CTAs, because we wanna track if someone's actually clicking through that to go view this data, because this is data from search engine land. I'm going to choose right here where my cursor is blinking to insert a CTA, because you want to have a CTA on the top as someone's getting into the content, and then as a best practice, later in the content, we usually place ours at the bottom. But you do want to test that, because that's where you get this data from. I'll show you here in a second. So inside of here, we're going to click on insert, not image, that's not what I wanted to do, hang on. We're going to go ahead and click insert, let's put our cursor back there, insert call to action here. So I click call to action. Now this is where you want to remember what you've named things, because right now, just because it created the CTA, the two most recent ones are going to be here. But if it's a CTA that, let's say you've written 7 different blog posts about case studies and how to do them, and then you want to use the same CTA in all of those blog posts, you might not have it appear here on top. So you want to make sure you know what you're looking for. So I'm going to insert the image version here and click. So you just basically select it and then click insert. And since I've already set up where that's gonna go inside of the blog post, I don't have to worry about, you know, saying, putting a hyperlink together and all that sort of thing. So I'm just gonna click save. And then basically what this looks like is this here. So that's how to insert a CTA as an image. And then I'm gonna show you the same thing applies for this. When I go insert CTA for a button, and I'm gonna click insert. And see how that just doesn't quite look as right here in the blog post. But if I was doing this in an email, that would be very relevant. So here I'm going to delete this, and then we would go back and insert that CTA we just talked about with the image, click on insert, and then save. So one last thing with CTAs before we're almost near the end, but here I'm going to show you this is the CTA over on this page that we call this the bottom CTA. But basically this is, we called it dark image, you know, underscore 10 things before HubSpot. This is a resource you would get if you're thinking about buying HubSpot, and we want you to think, okay, here's an ebook you should probably read. So we've been using that CTA for quite some time, and you'll see that we have 2,746 views on that specific CTA. And it's not on that, just on that blog post. We use that on multiple blog posts that talk about HubSpot. So if we write about HubSpot, typically what we want to do is put that same CTA in, because that's essentially our conversion opportunity. So we've got all of these views here. Of those views, we've got 126 clicks. And this here tells us that, what is that conversion ratio or that conversion percentage of people that view the page and who actually clicks on it, and then how many submissions have we gotten from that CTA. So again, there's other CTAs for that content offer, but this one specifically looks like this. And then, you know, we've got basically the placements report down here, which is a little bit more detailed version of what appears here. If you have any questions about CTAs, go ahead and drop a comment below this video and we'll address them, whether it's pointing you to a resource or we can address them in a future video as well. For more tips, tricks, and how-tos, hit that subscribe button and we'll have a video coming at you next week.